Bulkhead fittings. They come in many thread configurations. The two most common thread configurations are JIC bulkheads, and this is a 9/16 JIC bulkhead fitting. This is a 3/8 BSP bulkhead fitting. As you can see, the 3/8 bulkhead fitting is chunkier, more solid, but the actual bore size are quite similar. So they'll fit the same size hose inside diameter. So designed for 3/8 hose. That's why I can't get that nut on, because I'm using the wrong nut. So what are the advantages of bulkhead fittings? Bulkhead fittings are when you want to go through a wall, whether that's a wall in a bulkhead, like on a ship, like a watertight compartment, from one compartment to another compartment. When you want to go from the inside of a tank to the outside of the tank, whether you want to go through the floor of a truck, for example, you've got a hose on the inside of the truck and you want to run the hose to the outside of the truck. So for this example, let's just assume this is the floor of a truck, or it could be a wall, or it could even be the top of a tank. Yeah, so you could, if you made the hole big enough, put the hose through. The problem with putting the hose through is that you don't have a watertight, airtight, dust-tight seal. The other problem is you could also create chafing, whereas the edges of this, if there's vibration and there's any movement, as the hose moves in the hole, it'll actually start to wear out the rubber and then start to wear into the steel, and eventually the hose will fail. With a bulkhead fitting, film from underneath or not? You see what I'm doing?
Yeah.
So you now have a connection on the outside and you have a connection on the inside. So you have a hose that you can connect from here, which will then run to wherever you want it to run to. If there's other things above it, you can then add a 90 degree adapter, or you could run a what's called a run T. Yeah? And what does a run T allow you to do? It allows you to connect one hose that connects here, and one hose that connects here. Right? Which could work, yeah? And then you have the underneath side where you can connect another hose, whether that's, again, a 90 degree fitting or whether you use a 90 degree adapter, and then you can run that hose anywhere you like, anywhere you like. Alternatively, if you don't have 90 degree fittings, you use a 90 degree adapter. Same thing. You can run your hose that way, you can run your hose that way. This could be inside a tank. So this could be going down inside the oil level of the tank down to a strainer or into a pump, for example. And the pump is running inside the tank and it's pressurizing, sucking the oil, pressurizing the oil. You've got pressurized oil coming up through the tank. This could be the wall of the tank. This could be under the oil level and then coming out and then distributing where you want it to go. Or for this case, connecting to your valve bank. The beauty of adapters is that you can continuously change and modify things so everything looks nice and tidy. So it actually everything looks, runs tidily with a minimum amount of interference. For example, in this case, this hose is too long, but you could run that hose in a nice, neat manner into there. So that's what you're looking at here is what's called a run tee. Run tee. It's called a run tee because the female is on the top and it's running. This is called a branch tee, where the female's on the bottom of the tee. You could do that. Again, you could run, you could connect your hoses. So you could use this where, again, where you're limited in room, there's other equipment or other parts of the machine above it, and you need something low profile to be able to distribute to the left or to the right. Okay. So that's a branch tee, that's a bulkhead, that's a run tee.